Now, remember the times when an 8K TV cost about 23,000 ringgit or more? And remember when having an 8K TV is considered overkill? Well, not anymore, my friend. This is the Samsung Neo QLED 8K QN800C, one of the latest 8K TV lineups from Samsung, which comes at a price of 17,699 ringgit. Now, before you freak out and click off from this video, because yes, while technically not extremely affordable, we are talking about getting a future-proof 8K resolution, so besides that high pixel, let's together see what's great about the TV. Firstly, do we really need a native 8K TV right now when a lot of content does not come in native 8K? Well, not really. But if you want a huge TV, say above 65 inch or more, you should really consider it. Now, this variant that I'm reviewing is the 75 inch. So you know how when people say the bigger is better? Well, it's all about the pixel size, my friend. Because the bigger the TV, it's either you increase the size of the individual pixels to fill in the space or just increase the number of pixels in between. Now, as you can imagine, having bigger pixel size means blockier and blurrier picture, especially if you get closer to the screen. But Samsung uses the technology they call Quantum Matrix Technology Pro, which is actually three features packed into one. There's the 14-bit HDR contrast, quantum mini LED, and shape adaptive control. And what all of this essentially do is to give better contrast, high brightness, while reducing blooming. Now, if you're unfamiliar with what the term blooming means, is where you get this halo or glowing effect when a bright subject is on a dark background, and the only technology that could completely eliminate this is a high-quality OLED. But you know how pricey that these OLED TVs can get, especially for an 8K TV. So this is way much cost efficient and of course looking visually really great because of that technology. Plus it's also Pantone validated for color accuracy. But then you may ask, 4K on an 8K screen, is it gonna be blurry? Well, here's where the magic happens, because Samsung's QN800C has a few tricks up its sleeve, which is called the Neural Quantum Processor 8K Real Depth Enhancer Pro and the Auto HDR Remastering. Now, this may sound all complicated with all these kind of terms, but it's all AI working its magic. Because it uses 64 neural networks and upgraded AI deep learning, where essentially all those empty pixels will be filled in accurately as the AI can make it still have better texture, richer details, and eye-watering brightness, even when you're watching HDR content. So yes, this is not just marketing terms, because as you guys can clearly see that it works very well since this whole entire video was shot on 6K. Probably time for us to get an 8K camera, eh? So this is especially true when you're scaling from 4K to 8K, because I remember the days when 4K was new in the market, playing 1080p videos on it was just blocky and crappy because of the absence of this kind of technology. And to be fair, I was kind of expecting that it might be the same for this particular TV, but it did not happen over here. So all in all, it was very well detailed. Even if you get up close, you will hardly notice any pixels, especially at a normal viewing distance. Now, watching a native 8K content would be definitely better, but technology has progressed so much that I don't think that 90% or even 95% of audience would totally notice this. But don't expect any miracles though, because you can't use that 360p video on YouTube and try to upscale it to look good. Be realistic, guys. Now, as for gaming, this is definitely one of the better TVs for it. Now, this 8K screen can step up to 120Hz for a super smooth gameplay using the Motion Accelerator Turbo Plus. Now, I tested several games like Forza Horizon 5, and indeed, it was a seamless experience. Now, it is also officially AMD FreeSync Pro compatible, and also has ALLM or Auto Low Latency mode for faster inputs and almost a very lag-free experience. Now, another lag-free experience you can get is by liking and subscribing to Adam Lobo TV. Now, it just takes 2 seconds to hit those two buttons. I'll be externally grateful. And don't forget to subscribe and join our community Discord channel to discuss the latest in tech together. And do drop by at our website at www.adamlobotv for a written version of this video. All the links will be in the description, and many thanks in advance. Okay, another major aspect that I would like to talk about is the sound. Now, sound at least is half of your viewing experience, right? I mean, think about how many times that you're distracted by your phone while watching Netflix, and then you hear a jaw-dropping sound, and then, oh, what happened? and then you rewind again. Yes, it does happen to me, and I'm sure it happens to you. Now, the built-in TV audio is more than enough for casual listening, where it uses something called the OTS Pro, where the sound comes from every area of the TV, not just at the center. However, for the best sound experience that you can probably get is of course the Q-Symphony compatible soundbar, like this Q-Series soundbar, the HW Q990C. So how this Q-Symphony works is that both the TV and the soundbar speakers will work together to give you a better surround experience that is through 11.1.4 channels. So yeah, Samsung is the only brand that allows the TV speakers and the soundbar to work hand in hand to create and form a 3D surround sound. Now couple that with the Adaptive Sound Pro AI, it will produce a more immersive sound experience. It roars and rumbles with a satisfying thump, especially when you watch action movies. It is also Dolby Atmos and DTS:S certified, as well as being compatible with Apple's AirPlay 2. Then if you're a smart home nerd like me, well, you'll be pleased to know that smart things is a huge thing on this TV. Smart things, huge things, that rhymed. Because you can detect, connect, and display all of your devices on the screen thanks to the Zigbee and Thread compatibility. Then there's also the multi-view, which I think parents could really take advantage of. So you can display different content on one TV, and since these TVs can get really big, playing your show and Cocomelon on the side could be a very viable option. Now another quick tip that you can use with SmartThings is that you can color calibrate your TV just by using your phone. I tried it out and it worked super well, especially with the basic settings, where you can even dial it further using the professional mode. Alright, so that's the tech side of things, but how about the actual physical TV itself? Well, it's industrial design and a super heavy metal base. It's definitely suitable for most homes out there. Now, the best part is that there is the One Connect hub, where either you can place it at the back of the TV, but what I've done is to place it underneath, at my TV cabinet, where I can connect all of my peripherals or any other additional devices without having any wires or cables on the TV cabinet. Because all of this connects to one single wire to everything to the TV, so less clutter with the added convenience. But of course, having the soundbar on the TV cabinet would be even nicer. And speaking of the TV cabinet, you can always place the soundbar like what I've done over here, which overall complements the TV's looks. Alright, so there you have it, the Samsung Neo QLED 8K QN800C is definitely a beast of an 8K TV. So let me know, what kind of content that you would like to watch on an 8K TV? Let me know in the comment section below and let's discuss it over there.